To our about classes. Today I would like to draw involute curve for a circle of radius 25. So first of all, what you need to do is now we need to draw a circle of radius 25. So we'll take the scale of length 2.5 2.5. Now we'll draw circle of radius 2.5. So perimeter of the circle is 156. Perimeter is nothing but 2 pi r, and this will keep you as 2 into 22 by 7 into 25. 156 mm. Now I'll take length of 150 mm.
This will come somewhere else.
Now we'll divide this tangent in equal part, 12 equal part. So we'll divide this line into 12 equal part, and we'll make 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and this is 12. So don't use a pen while drawing the curve. So for visualization, I'm using this color pens. You need to use only HB pencils. Similarly, we need to divide this circle into 12 equal parts. Now we have labeled this line like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 line. So what we need to do is we will label the circle as below 1, 2, 3. In this sequence you have to label it. It is not mandatory, but for our convenience we are doing like that. 10, 11, 6, 12. Now we need to draw tangent at all the points. supposed to draw the tangent in this way, but unfortunately I have drawn the tangent in this direction. So that means we can consider this point P, and from here this point P we are opening the thread. So we have to draw in this way. So what you need to do is, when the thread is opened through this one and when it is tangent at this point, so basically what you do, so when this much of length is opening and unwrapping, so what is the trajectory of this point we have to find. So this arc length is equal to this length. So from point 1 we will cut the point. Now second point will take this length 2, and through this one will cut it. Now 3. Now we'll go 4. So we'll change it. So this will 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This 11, this is 12. Three. Now we'll go for 4.4. Now we'll go for 5. We'll take the length of 1.5. Then we'll take 6. Now we'll take the 7th. Eleven. And last one is 12. Now with the help of HB pencil we'll join those lines. This curve is called as involute curve. So this one P1, P2, P4, P5, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11, P12. So if we'll open this thread in this way, then our involute curve will be like this one in this way. So in that case, we need to draw the tangent in these directions. Now we'll draw the tangent. Now we'll draw the tangent and normal on the involute curve. So we'll take some point M on the involute curve and we'll join M with the center. Now we'll find the perpendicular bisector. We'll find the perpendicular bisector or CM. Perpendicular bisector. So this is the meter point. So now we'll make CM as a diameter and we'll draw the semicircular arc. Semicircular arc. So the semicircular arc is cutting at this point. Suppose then this is end point. Now we will join CM point.